Hey everybody, Rodimon here. Thanks for tuning in to Starsector. So picking up where we left off, we have been on a, I guess for lack of a better term, survey mission, where we are surveying all of the planets near and around the core systems in order to hopefully find a really good system for colonization. And that is what we are continuing to do. I actually want to drop these ships back at Corvus because I'm not going to be able to do any transverse jumping, plus I'm slower. So let's go do that right now, and then we'll get back to the survey. The surveying the local sector, or whatever you want to call it. I'm quite excited to get these new battle cruisers or carriers and the battleship into service, but obviously don't really need them in service to do simple survey missions, so that's why I'm dropping them off. Make sure our transponder's on, or we'll piss off everybody here. Nobody will like that. Alright, let's transfer some goods here. We are going to put our ships away, so the mothballed legion that's perfect, the mothballed legion that's damaged, and then all these other ships I'm going to end up selling. They'll make good cash on the black market. Alright, so on the normal market, not the black market, I'm going to sell the Tachyon Lance. I don't want blueprints being sold on the black market. I'm not entirely certain that the black market is... I'm pretty sure they're pirates. But yeah, let's do that. And this is another way to offload all of the goods that we've been collecting, I suppose. Alright, going to fleet here. Black market, we will sell the mud skippers. I don't really need them. The Cerberus, more mud skippers, the Vigilance, even the Gemini. I don't need damaged ships. We've got... I wouldn't actually mind buying a new Colossus, but not a Pirate Colossus. This is a, like, damaged Pirate Colossus for extra storage. And let's see. We have a bit of a crew. Too many crewmen, so I'm going to dismiss. And I'm going to buy a bunch of things on the open market here. I'm not all that worried about the money. We do have a Gamma Core, and do I have a mule? I forget if I brought my mule around. No, I don't really have a mule with me. How close is a Tritachyon world? There's one pretty close. Oh yeah, there's Valhalla. Alright, so let's jump to Valhalla real quick. And just hand these in. Actually, you know what? In fact, jump back. Sorry, this is kind of a waste of fuel, but I want to put away all of the other weapons and the like. In fact, what I could do to save my some time is just to put all this away. I can turn in the Gamma Cores later. I suppose it's entirely possible to find more out on my excursions. Alright, doing a little transverse jump, and let's see, checking the world map here, we skipped over Uruk because it was dangerous. I think we skipped over here for the same reason, but it's on the way to Jiao, or whatever it's called, so we'll hit it up anyway. So my hope for this episode is that I manage to survey enough of the worlds around that I'll be satisfied settling somewhere. Drover class light carrier. Let's poke around. Ooh, it had harvested organs in it. Nice. Nothing like finding a organ farm out in deep space. That's, you know, totally normal. These are just barren worlds. I'll poke around just to see if there's stuff. There was actually maybe a debris field or a fleet up this way. seems to be moving. Oh, it's a legion, another legion. And I can recover it. All right, I'm not going to recover this one. I don't need three legions. I know it seems crazy to be turning down a battleship, but I don't really have any regrets. Just having a ton of legions. It's actually not a ship type you need a lot of. I mean, you could build your fleet around having a bunch of fighters. It just might be a little weird, but that one in particular is more damaged than the other ones I've recovered. Might I add that in all of my playing of Starsector, it is very rare to see and recover as many of the super ships that I have been grabbing. I can't tell you why I'm finding a ton of them, but hey, my RNG, the RNG for this galaxy generation just must be with me. Oop, gaze into the void, got caught by that storm. Only one ship ever gets damaged when you hit a storm. Alright, so there's a decent amount of planets here. Let's hop into the gravity well. And most of these planets are crummy little bombarded, destroyed, etc. Certainly not going to find any arable land here. There won't be any farming. Just curious if there's ruins. There doesn't even seem to be ruins. Okay, transverse jumping out. Three planets. I would say a three planet system is just about the minimum that you'd be looking for. Nope, there's something there. Oh, oddly enough, I'm going to survey here anyway, but there was no... Usually the desert world, you'd expect there to be ruins, but there wasn't. Is a debris field, though. In one of my comments, there was a comment about how you can resurvey over and over and over. A salvage vessel reduces the risk to ships when you do that. But, oh yeah. This is, again, a fairly habitable world. I mean, it has a hazard of less than 200 and no ruins. This system is interesting. Generally, deserts are, don't fly into the sun. Are a little bit more habitable than the average. Whoa, more debris fields. When you resurvey the debris fields, each time you resurvey it, you have a chance to find something rare or special or, you know, stuff like that. What is this? Already known Thunderwing blueprint. So if you wanted to be, for lack of a better term, completionist, you would survey it until you know, to make sure there's nothing unusual about the ruins. There might be a little research station here. I'm gonna have to fly into the corona for it. Oh, no, it's an error probe. And it has some automated defenses. Well, I come ready for that. So, here's one thing. We are fighting in the corona, because that's where this, you know, the domain era probe was. Which means our peak time is lower, you know, our combat readiness degradation is faster. Basically, the longer this fight takes, the more damage that our ships will sustain. So, unlike normal fights where, like, you could kind of take your time with it. In this one specifically, you should, you know, if you're ever fighting in a dangerous area like this, you should wrap it as fast as you're able. And this is the last ship. Alright, claim victory. Pick three wreckage. Whole bunch of Vulcan cannons. Those guys like their cannons. Max Power and Hector are both ready to level up, as am I. We got survey data for Theros. And there is stuff to salvage. And then there's also the debris field. Oh, come on. I didn't mean that. Alright. We are out of the corona. So, the new information is survey data for... some world, I guess. A tragedy. It was one of these worlds. This one. Theros the gas giant. It has plentiful volatiles, dense atmosphere, high gravity. Okay, well, cool. Guess that probe was surveying over there at one point and then got stuck and caught. Oh. There was something there. Yeah, you know, I think it warrants me going back. I jumped the gun. Let's also level up. Let's see what I want. I would like to start getting ballistics and energy weapon range. Oh, it's another probe. With more automated defenses. At least this time, I'm not deep inside of the corona of a sun. Of a star, so no rush here. Unlike the remnants that are actually pretty dangerous, these domain era stuff are like pre-shield, and I never find them particularly dangerous. The only danger is my inaccuracy. That one's done. This is the last ship. Alright. No problems there. Wreckage. Looks good. My fleet leveled up. And I have a location for a salvage ship. Alright, so, my captains. Let's see, Max. Actually, I'm gonna do Helmsman. And Bora. 20% damage to ships of destroyer size or larger. Sounds pretty good. Yeah. Okay. Now, the survey ship is not actually super far away. Quite glad that I made that little jaunt out to whatever the intel flicker that I saw. But I'm taking a little bit longer than last episode for, you know, ripping through the surveys. The problem being I'm... Okay, there's not anything there. There's no planets, rather. You could tell there's no gravity wells for them. So. There's no need to go there. There's two planets here. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna double check the other area. You never know. You never know. We've got an arid world. That's usually pretty colonizable, but because there's only two worlds, it's unlikely I'm gonna make my home here. I'm gonna survey it, even though it doesn't have, poor farmland. Alright, even though it doesn't have, ruins. Surveying, worlds that are fairly colonizable, you can sell the intel data for more. It does use up supplies, but I'm not starving for supplies. I'll survey here too. Some volatiles. Too bad. That could have been a cool world. Right, let's just transverse jump out of here. Alright, I'll check on that. Red giant. Sometimes there's... Nope, not this time. I mean... So here's the thing. It's always possible that there's something hidden on a system like that. But the amount of effort it would take to properly... I mean, the amount of effort it takes to properly serve an entire system and scan sweep the whole area, etc., etc., it's lengthy. And that's pretty much why I don't do it. Is it is time prohibitive. And here's a little red dwarf. I'm just going to go here to mark it off as I've been. A little sensor burst. Again, not surprising it doesn't have anything. Okay, so Big Ping had one of the surveys, right? Oh no, maybe even beyond Big Ping. I'm not going to lose focus on what I am trying to do. I am trying to survey the local systems. At this point, there's a few up here that I have not surveyed that's actually pretty close to the local cluster. Maybe the Deinos systems here. So I'm going to resupply back at the Hegemony systems and then survey the last few and then make some sort of decision about where I'm going. Oof. I tried to be clever and emergency burn through there and ended up hitting storms twice. I mean, if you're wealthy and you have a lot of supplies, you can just keep hitting storms. It's sort of like, I don't know. It's not that penalizing. Alright, transponder on. Luckily the game reminds me about that. Or otherwise they would come flying at me very, very angry. I probably, for monthly income, what, I have like a month or two left? 3 months. So, for the black market, I'm gonna sell a lot of this stuff, and then the open market, I will sell... Oh, that's not blueprint. I'll sell the blueprint. Black market, I will sell the wing. Okay, we are all set to go. As you can see, my money's basically staying even. Oh, one other thing I should check is if there is... Oh yeah, there's a Colossus for me to buy if I would want it. There's also some salvage rigs. Yeah, I'll do both. I should have probably checked the black market first, but that's okay. So this Colossus here... Let's repair them. Go to my fleet. So this second Colossus is going to allow me to carry a lot more stuff, which is really, really good. And you are going to be named Yubin. Augmented dry field, expanded cargo holds, nav relay. All right. Augmented dry field, expanded cargo holds. And nav relay. That's what we've been adding to these things. And then 1 point in capacitors. No weapons. Weaponless. You would think that weaponless is a problem, but if I ever get ganked by a giant fleet of pirate ships and I want to retreat, it's on us, honestly, not going to really matter. If a cargo ship has weapons or not, they're dead. Let's do Oh, you know what? I could start putting efficiency overhauls on a bunch of my ships. So this reduces the amount of fuel use and minimum crew and maintenance that ships need, and that will help to make my fleet a lot more efficient. But I'm sort of curious. What I'm curious about is alright, so my max speed is actually lowered from that gantry. So let's refit that. The salvage rig is going to get something that makes it faster. Military subsystems. Perfect. And then I can still afford the efficiency overhaul and one capacitor. And now I should be moving. Yep, I'm moving around at 20. So in order to move around to 20, I need the max burn to be like 9, because I have burn plus 1. So the max burn of these are 7. I do need the augmented field drives on those. So what I'm saying is get rid of a lot of this stuff and put efficiency overhauls here. And then we can put the I can't do a cargo because there are 2 logistics now. So I can put the nav relays on. It also frees up a teeny bit of space for possibly weapons. Now I did laugh at the idea of having some weapons here, but what I will do is put two little light machine guns on each ship. All right, so the cargo in lieu of efficiency, and then nav relays, and then 2 little point defense LMGs. All right. The tanker here should also probably get an efficiency overhaul. And this will just make it cheaper to use these ships. Where is it? Why am I totally blinking on it? Oh, you know what? Maybe these can't be efficient. Oh no, it's right in front of me. Of course it is. Oh my lord. Let's reduce the capacitors, add a nav relay, and put a railgun on the back. Salvage rigs don't have weapons. Salvage rigs make salvaging stuff makes salvaging stuff less dangerous. So a little efficiency overhaul, and what is this, the mud skipper? Additional berthing. And a teeny little, I don't know why I'm putting weapons on these things. Oh, there was a weapon on that. Oops. Okay. We're all set. Ready to fly. I am over capacity on fuel, so let me sell some of that and buy some supplies. As you can see, my supply max, or my storage max, is up by a lot. Because we got the second, we got Yubin, right? All right, so there's a lot of storm activity just north. Something to consider if I'm going to be colonizing up here is I'll be traversing these storms for a long, long time. Oops, still hit that. Come on. When you're on sustained drive, you drift a lot. Well, there's one planet here, so unlikely I won't be settling here, but I can always check. This also seems to be a light path. They probably have a pirate base here or something. Oh, it's actually a desert world. It's not a terrible world. But I'm almost certain that there's... Yeah, there it is. Yep. Bunch of Luddites that want to murder me. Hodhold. Well, oh, that's gonna suck. They caught me. Oh boy. Accept the comm request. I can pay a tithe or get attacked by them. I'm gonna pay the tithe because I don't have my full fleet here and don't really feel like getting... Okay, can you quit shaking me down? I'm just trying to poke around your planet here. Your unsurveyed planet. God, what jerks. Now you know why I hate the Luddites. I hadn't actually had any run-ins on this playthrough yet, but now you get it. I'm going to be back to, at some point, to wipe them out of that system. Okay, so there's two other systems over here that I wanted to check out. Maybe Uz, too. So let me, before I do that, let me go to Dinos. What a waste of money. Stupid Luddites. Alright, so we got some remnants here. Rocky Metallic World and a Barren World. There doesn't really seem to be anything here. Out we go. I guess Petra Tartarus is another system that it's close enough to the core. Ooh, Arid. Arid with ruins. I like that. Poor farmland. Well, that's not great, but also volatiles, which is interesting. Although the ruins were quite the bust. There was really not much there. What is this other world? Is a barren world? Nope, maybe a probe? Ooh, equipment cache. Don't mind if I help myself. Pirate blueprints and the Tempest class frigate blueprint. Quite nice. I'll learn that. Oh, so there's a big flow. Okay, let's not do that. Big old pirate fleet waiting here to ambush us. There's probably a bounty on his head. Oh boy, he is really fast. So he did a emergency burn after me right after I did my emergency burn. So it was like Tom and Jerry there. All right, let's get on out of this system. Oh, I didn't mean to do an interdiction pulse. Misclick. I feel bad having to run from stuff, but it's just because I have most of my, most of the strong ships on dry dock right now. I don't have a full force. That's a cool looking brown dwarf. There is no reason to be here, because there's like nothing here. Cool. Out we go. I mean, you just gotta check, right? Sometimes you just gotta check. Alright, over to Rama. And there's three planets here. It has a low warning beacon. Oh, surveyable ruined arid world with poor farmland. And a beta core. Proximity charge launcher. Not bad, not bad. Now what else is, oh, barren desert. This is a potential. This system actually has some potential for colony. More ruins. Just some organics. Some broken down ships. Oh, that's a dormant fleet. Part of me is, you know, I'm going to do the initial survey here, just to these gas giant and the baron. 75%, or 175, and 200. There's also a bunch of stable points, and yeah, this system is actually looking pretty good. I'll have to compare and contrast. Another 175 with, there's the star itself. Now there might be some significant, well, not significant because the danger level was not that high, but there might be a bunch of, let's survey here as well. Might be a bunch of fleets around that I gotta be careful of. So now that I've got the survey gantry, it does make the salvage gantry rather, does make salvaging this stuff a little less dangerous. Like I'm losing some heavy machinery every time, but not people anymore. Okay, they're coming after me. There's ruins here as well. More poor farmland. And more, that is that the same pirate blueprint? Yeah, it is. Okay, I'm gonna bust a move. There is one more planet left. But yeah, there's a lot of potential in this system. Very much so. I would have to survey it a little bit more, but 200. Okay. Looks pretty good. So, Rama Star System. Roger that. With that in mind, I might not go any further. I might just sheet him and ooze, and then whatever this is probably going to be the last of my survey. Maybe not even that. Yeah, I don't know. Petra? I should go to Petra too. It is about as far out as Rama. Alright, so this is another low danger beacon. And there's a bunch of remnants. There's survey here. Extensive ruins. Oh, midline. That gives me access to manufacture some weapons and wings and hulls and stuff. Another gamma core. A whole lot of transplutonics. So transplutonics are worth 200 pop, whereas metals are worth 30. So I want to grab as many of the transplutonics as possible because they're worth considerably more. And then what I'm going to do is actually put the rest of the cargo pods here into a stable orbit, using up a bunch of supplies so I can come back and loot it some more. So now they're not going to drift away randomly. I have no idea why I surveyed here. But I can take some of that. Alright, there's a comm relay here and a bunch of debris fields. Alright. I installed the comm relay. These things... I think what's happening is they're... Ooh. Survey data for Tannin. In that debris field. These ships are like kind of gaining... I don't know where Tannin is. Alright, where is Tannin? Tannin is in Yaw. Let's take a look if that's any decent. It's an irradiated world, which looks real nasty. Has a lot of good resources. Whoa, you were trying to interdict me. Means that they wanted to fight. Sometimes they just interdict you and then they run away. I'm actually not going to access these debris fields. I don't have storage space for them anymore. But there seems to be something... Yeah, there's a lot of wealth here to be discovered. Okay, yeah, research stations and everything. I'll be back. And then orbital habitat. Yeah, I'll definitely be back. All right, so let's transverse out of here. Go sell our spoils and then come back. I feel like anytime I try to set out a mission for myself, like, oh, I want to colonize, I'm going to find... I mean, that's the thing about Star Sectors. You are constantly finding stuff... Stories unfold, etc. Oh, storm's gonna get me. It's always Talon that suffers from the storm. a quote-unquote distress call. I ain't no fool. It's a trap. Just assume that they're always traps, and you'll never be disappointed. Gonna black market. Let me sell the blueprints on open market, and then I'll black market everything else, minus the gamma cores. So 46,000 for that. Maybe I'll keep the heavy mauler. Keep the flat cannons as well. I don't really need the money so desperately. So I'll even keep the arbalist. They're not all that rare, but... Alright, so that's a pretty good amount of money. We want to resupply, refuel. That's a lot of supplies and fuel. Let's actually get more crew. I'm going to max out my crew. And... fleet. It doesn't hurt to check what they got, but no. Alright, so let's get back to that system... before I forget about all the treasures that they have. Go ahead, scan me, I don't care. Didn't actually mean to do an emergency burn, I meant to do a sustained burn. Well, at least after buying the cargo ship and the salvage and paying off two ransoms or two tithes to the Luddite path. My money's back to kind of normal. That was... I got... the last payment from my stipend. So... my monthly costs are going to be going up. Now, here's a derelict salvage rig. I don't want it. But I will loot it. So now, month after month, I'll be paying for... I mean, I guess it was already paying for the crew and the, all that stuff out of pocket already, but more so now. Alright, there is so much good stuff. So that cargo pod's going to be stable there for a while, but I'm first going to poke into this research station. So what do we got? We have the Odyssey-class battlecruiser blueprint. Now... ooh, another plasma cannon. That's incredible. Some Mulineers. Gamma cores. I'm going to learn this, but honestly, if you never intend to make an Odyssey class, you should just sell it. It's worth half a mil. But I wanna learn it. We have Perdition Wing Blueprint and Thunder Wing. I already know that. Some Mining Pod and Talons. Annihilator Rockets. All right. But I like to actually collect all blueprints. Which is why. Alright, Heavy Burst Laser. They're okay. Alright, that's enough of that for me. Alright, we've already gone through that debris field. This has extensive ruins. Cool. High-tech blueprint package, low-tech blueprint package, techs of all levels blueprint package. And I leveled up just from doing this sort of survey thing. So let's go target leading accuracy for auto-firing weapons. That's very, very useful for point defense and things like that. Hit this orbital habitat. Yes, I'm going to consider recovery. I'm going to recover the freighter here to free up some more space. I can sell it later. More Luddite path package. And let's poke through the debris field. Ooh, some drugs. What else was there here? There was so much else. Come on, little ships. You know you're not going to fight me. So quit harassing me. All right, let's grab the cargo that I set aside. Some of it. The rest of it, I'm just going to let it go. It wasn't particularly expensive. I have all the transplutonics on me. Right, there's a whole bunch of stuff this way. Oh no, I was misreading the map. There's still some. Let's poke over closer to the. Supply cache. Nice. Man, this system is just a gift. I am just about filled to the brim, so let's head on out of here. Heading back to civilization to sell our hull. And looking at the time elapsed, I do believe I'm gonna owe you all an apology. Cause. Yeah, I'm kind of running out of time, and I certainly am no closer to having anything colonized. Rama's looking pretty good. I do have to do a little side-by-side comparison, Rama versus, that stupid sumo is so slow. That's why I'm going 14. Where is its damage, its engine system? Degraded engines. Yeah, that would explain why I'm so unbelievably slow. I was curious about that. Helps me store more stuff, but... And there we go. Minus about 16 grand for operating costs, now that I no longer have the stipend. Totally normal. Let's not warp in at the star. Transponder is on. And... Let's sell to... Oh, I definitely just pissed them off with all the weird illegal goods that I had. I had, like, organs and stuff. Recreational drugs, rather. I should not have allowed that scan. Should have just burned. But, alright, let's trade that and get that out. Open market for the blueprints. Let's go ahead and ditch the slow ship that's killing me in my soul. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Come on now. Oh, I'm over. I'm a dummy. Nope, don't touch me. Go away, go away, go away. No scanning me. I'm out of here. There's another thing I wanted to do before I end this episode. You know what? I feel bad. Maybe I'll have it go a little bit longer. Let's get the survey of Tartarus up, and then that's where I'll call it. Hit a few storms. All right, here we are at the Petra Tartarus system. There doesn't seem to be much to survey, so this should go fast. Oh, this is a pirate world. Hello, pirate fleet. All right, well, I guess my... Instead of surveying here, the last thing I'll do is beat up some pirates. Fitting ending, I suppose. All these ships... Actually, you follow you. You follow me. The carriers tend not to be able to hold their own so well. Silly pirates, I'm gonna trash you. I don't even have my shields up. Come on. Look at them, they're all like too scared to fight. Alright, let me go kill this Shrike. It's funny that we're the same class ship. Like, Shrikes are technically the same size as my Sunder, but the Sunders are such glass cannons that if you know what you're doing, you can split ships in two that are, like, honestly even twice the size of you. Because it has a large energy slot, and I have a plasma cannon. That's, like, just nighty-night territory here, as you can see. Vent. I got a few free shots on me, but that's all right. I'm coming to get you. Ooh, that torpedo is gonna. Oof. Yeah, that was a nice shot, Shrike. I saw that coming in. The red hot glow of death. All right, and what do they have left? They have another little enforcer, pirate class, damaged. And soon to be very dead. You don't even know which way to put your shields up. Alright, well, that was it. That was the last little fight. A little kite got away. I'm going to let them go. I don't really care. I don't want to recover a super damaged ship. So thank you for all the wreckage. Thank you for attacking me. Alright guys, well that's all the time I have for this episode. Sorry that I wasn't able to start colonizing, but I will weigh my options. It's likely that Rama will be the sector of choice, but we'll see. If you have any tips, tricks, feedback for me, drop me a line. If you are a patron of mine and would like a ship or captain named after you, just reach out to me on Discord and I'll catch you all later. Thanks for watching, everybody. Adios.